doesn't.
It's a backhand move.
See that? Look at the footwork, Scott.
Oh, yeah, you step across.
He's that's
one handed back.
Yeah, we're going again.
Well, that's what we're doing. Okay.
Jake, you're up.
Okay, therefore, in a post game analysis of tennis, tennis employed a ratio of 80 to 20, 80 referring to the anaerobic respiration system and 20 to the aerobic respiration system. To test my hypothesis, I need to test the lactic acid threshold, which refers to the VO2 max. This result will give an indication of an individual's maximal aerobic capacity. We know that when the amount of lactic acid produced by the breakdown of carbohydrates and glycolysis exceeds the point in which it's removed from the muscle and begins to accumulate in the bloodstream is the lactic acid threshold. This threshold infers the maximum amount of oxygen of an individual measured in millimeters of oxygen per kilogram body weight per minute. I believe to test this for tennis players, we use the beat test because the beat test aims to monitor the development of a tennis player's maximal oxygen uptake. It consists of shuttles that decrease in time intervals between each shuttle, between two cones measured 20 meters apart, and tennis is a lot of short sprints, so I thought this is the best way to do it. Once an individual has completed the test to the best of their fitness ability, VO2 max is determined from the MSF table, which is a table developed by the Department of Physical Education and Sports Science in some place, university, I can't say that, in 1987, using the highest level. So when you get the highest level, you just type it into a calculator and it just does it for you, tells you the VO2 max. For example, a female age 20 achieved level 11 shuttle 4, and this gives a VO2 max percentage of 51.4, and this is what we would. For a tennis player, one would expect to reach a lactic acid threshold quicker, i.e. a low percentage of tennis, because it mostly consists of short, sharp movements, as in the Federer and Leighton video. Additionally, once you have attained the VO2 max, you could get the respiratory exchange ratio, which gives an indication of the energy source one is utilizing, carbohydrates or fats. Okay, this graph represents the percentage of the particular energy systems that are utilized within tennis. It has been generated by the International Tennis Federation. We see that the largest percentage of energy is result from the phosphocretin system. This is another form of anaerobic energy that provides a medium form of energy for up to 15 seconds, the perfect amount energy for short rallies. Then we can see that the anaerobic lactate one is 20% and aerobic is 10%. My hypothesis stated that it consists of a ratio of 80%. I didn't include the phosphate cretin system because we learned about it in class. So yeah, but basically it's what's my hypothesis. To improve the ability, we want to improve the anaerobic stuff, which is via the high-intensity training intervals. So endurance training, so we have on an athletics chart, we do intervals of running 100 metres and jogging back, then 200 and jogging back, and the same, we do it over repetitions. And this will, that'll be whatever. Yeah, I'm finished. Yeah, I don't know.